Hello and welcome back to ExcelSev. Today I'm going to show you how you can create an electronic signature and use it in various applications such as Adobe Acrobat, Microsoft Excel, Microsoft Word, and Microsoft Outlook. Quick clarification: an electronic signature is quite different from a digital signature. An electronic signature is your handwritten signature that you do in your letters, checks, contract, etc. with a pen converted to an electronic form by scanning it or taking a photo of it. However, a digital signature is something which uses a software to create your signature which can be verified. You must have seen contracts, bank statements, etc. which when opened show you a message about verifying all signatures. Those are digital signatures which are authenticated mostly online. With that out of the way, let's begin. Here I have a handwritten signature which, as you can guess, is not anyone's actual signature and is just signature. We are going to work with this in this video. All I have done is wrote this on a piece of white paper and took a photo with my phone. As you can see, it's not a perfect photo. It has shadows and it is a bit dark considering it was on a white paper. But we are not worried about that. Now that you have it, you can simply start putting it as in your contracts and whatnots. But the issue is, this signature as it is won't look professional. Let me show you what I mean. If I am to put it in Word, you can see it doesn't look good. So we need to fix this so it gets from this to this. To get here, we need to get rid of the background in this photo. The background being the paper in the photo, we are going to remove it and just keep the signature bit. There are a number of ways to do it. Photoshop is your best bet. But I think not many of us are Photoshop wizards. So we are going to use a free and simple tool available to us. A nifty little website called remove.bg. I'm guessing BG is for background. I have it opened here and all we have to do is click here. Select our image and it does its magic. It gives you two options to download. One is HD, which requires creating an account with them, and the other one is SD, which is sufficient for us, so we'll go with that. That's half the battle won. We have our signature and we are ready to sign those contracts away. First up, the king of PDF readers, Adobe Acrobat. I have the free version, which is more than sufficient for our job today. Here is our sample contract and we have to sign here. Click on this pen icon and choose Add Signature, and we get three options. We can type our signature, which is automatically in a font which looks like handwriting. Neat. We can change the style from here, but we are not interested in typing. So we move to our next option up top, Draw. As it says, we can draw our signature here. With mouse or a digital pen, if you have it. I don't know about you, but I think not everyone has a digital pen and tablet, and drawing your signature by mouse will need multiple tries to get it just right. So let's get to the option we want, image. It asks for the image we want. Let's find it and select it. We also have an option to save it, which we are going to use. So let's put a check mark here. And now we have our signature as our mouse arrow. You can put it anywhere you want on the document. All we have to do is place where we want it and left click and done. If you think it's bigger than it should be or smaller, you can adjust that from here and drag it like so. Now save your PDF and you're done. Now this contract is ready to be sent with your very own signature. A bonus tip, you can even change the color of your signature here. Click on this icon and we have all these options to choose from. Just choose the color and it's done. Now we move to using the signature in Microsoft Word, which will be the second most use case scenario. We have the same contract in Word format here and we need to sign here. So we put a cursor here and then we go to Insert tab up here, then Picture and choose this device. Find your image and here we have some deformed image. Well, that's because Word doesn't handle images within text that good. So let's fix that. This one is easy. It's just supersized. So first we make it to the size we want, like so. But even then, putting this signature here has also deformed the table itself. To fix that, we gotta check this option and change the layout to behind text. Now it looks much better. Another bonus tip, if you have to move this signature or resize it, now you won't be able to click it, because in order to fix the layout, we had to send it behind the text. So to select it back, we go to Home tab, then all the way here, click on Select and then select Object. Now you can move it around or resize to your delight. Next up is Outlook. I'm using the Outlook new app, which is available in Windows by default and not the Microsoft 365 Outlook, because I guess most of us are not subscribed to Microsoft 365 plan. Don't worry, the principle in both the cases is same. If you are using Outlook 365, just follow these steps. They might not be in the same place, but the idea is the same. So we start by going in Settings, then Signature, then click this icon, which is the default picture icon in Microsoft apps. Again, find your image, and again, it's supersized, so let's fix that. Now, all we have to do is give this signature a name and you're good to go. Last but not the least, our Microsoft Excel. It's pretty simple in Excel. I would say the simplest of all the methods today. Just open your file, and for this video, we are going to use a salary slip file, which, by the way, we created from scratch in Excel using very simple formulas and automation. If you want to know how, I'll leave the link on top right and in the description. Moving on, we have to put a signature here, so let's go up top to Insert, select the picture option up here, and now we have two options. Mine is Excel 365 and hence these two options. If you are using an older version, you might not see this. By the way, there was another video I made specifically about images in Excel, which you should check. Again, I'll leave the link on top right and in the description. Once you have watched that video, you'll understand we have to choose the second option, Place Over Cells. Select this device and then it's the same drill. Find your image and voila, we have got a jumbo size signature here. Let's resize and reposition it like this and done. So that's how you create and use your electronic signature in Adobe Acrobat, Excel, Word, or Outlook. If you are using any other applications like maybe some other PDF reader, the process will be the same, barring the menu options. That's it for this video. I hope I was able to bring something new and interesting to you today, which I always try to, and hope you will subscribe, like, and share if you haven't already. I'll see you in the next one. Until then, happy spreadsheeting.